Hello, hi everybody. I am Thekla Petridou, a YouTuber, a psychologist, and an author. I am Greek Cypriot. Today it's Friday, the 13th of November 2020, and this is our weekly video in English. Today's subject, I think, is universal. It affects everybody. How to get through, how to cope emotionally with the lockdown. I made some coffee and I would like to drink a cup of coffee with you and discuss about this issue. In Greece, already people have been in the second lockdown since last week, last Saturday. In Cyprus, they are going there, which is the country I come from. And in several other European countries or other countries in the world, non-European countries, governments decide to hold people down, to make a lockdown in order to prevent the rapid spreading of coronavirus disease. On my YouTube channel, which is in Greek, we spend a lot of time with my followers during the first lockdown that happened in Greece and Cyprus from the middle of March till the end of May 2020, and now we're getting ready to be together via YouTube to get over the second lockdown. Being locked down is a difficult situation. It's abnormal. As human beings are social beings. We are social beings. We need to be with other people, to communicate with other people in order to feel fulfilled, emotionally fulfilled. We need connection. We need communication. And many people nowadays go through the lockdown either by themselves or trapped in a relationship which is not good for them. It makes us question why, after the first lockdown, so many relationships and marriages collapsed. There was a rise in divorce, not only in China, that was the first country that reported a rise in divorce after the end of their lockdown, which I think it lasted for at least 3 months in the Republic of China, but also other countries show similar statistics, that many marriages, many relationships finish during a lockdown, because it is extremely difficult to live in a very limited space with another person for such a long time, not being able to go out, not being able to socialize, not being able to have entertainment, not being able to go out for lunch, to go out for dancing, to go out clubbing, even to go to your own job, even to go to your work environment and get out of the house. During a lockdown, most of us are limited within the house. For me, personally, the first lockdown was a huge revelation. It helped me realize a lot of things about myself. It was a difficult period of my life, but it was a very beneficial one, because at the end of it, I got out wiser and more wealthy emotionally and spiritually. Not financially, though. Many people report that the first period of lockdown was spiritually and emotionally beneficial for them as an experience, and this they felt after the end of that experience. Now, going for the second lockdown, things are somehow more difficult. Last Saturday night, I had a live video on my channel in Greek, of course, because the main language of my channel is Greek. I am Greek. And on that live video, I had the opportunity to talk live with three very distinguished colleagues, psychologists, and the one is also a psychologist and a philosopher, to talk about ways to cope with the lockdown, and how this lockdown could be proven beneficial to us, or how we cope with it. Because some people have difficulty coping, and some other people, they are at a level where they can see that they can have some positive outcome from a lockdown. I will talk first about the people who find it difficult to stay inside. It is so normal. It is so very normal. It's so normal to feel that your life is wasted, your time is wasted. You don't have time, you don't have the opportunity to meet other people. You don't have the opportunity to exercise in nature or to exercise in a gym. You don't have the opportunity to attend social events. You don't have opportunities that you had before, and maybe you haven't even used, but now that you don't have them, you really do want them. You really do long to meet with other people, even people that you were bored of in the past. It's abnormal to keep humans limited in a flat or in a house. It's abnormal. It's so very natural for you to feel that you detest this. So my first piece of advice is to accept the fact that it sucks. Lockdown sucks. Yes, it sucks. It really sucks. It's an abnormal situation. We were not born and raised in order to be equipped to go through the lockdown. That's why I'm making this video. I do not believe that this video is going to solve the problems of everybody with lockdown. It might be proven beneficial to some people, I hope. So first of all, you allow yourself to be unhappy about the situation. You allow yourself to detest the lockdown. You allow yourself to feel bad about it. It is so normal. Secondly, do not allow yourself to lose your daily program. Even if you are locked in the house, you need to go on a program, on a daily program, in order to maintain normality in your life. It is essential for you to wake up sometime in the morning. I'm not saying to wake up at 5 a.m. or 6 a.m. or 7 a.m. or 8 a.m. Of course, you might have to wake up for work, because most of us, we work through our laptops, we work through our computers, through the internet. But even if you don't have to work, or if you can work at your own pace, please wake up in the morning time. You might wake up at 9 a.m. or 10 a.m. or even 11 a.m. But please do wake up in the morning, and please do sleep at night. It is proven by many psychological and biological research that sleeping at night time is beneficial for our brain. Sleep is absolute for us in order to maintain our physical, psychological, and emotional health and balance. Do not allow your sleep to be disturbed. Because what we've seen and during the first lockdown is that too many people, they made a total reversal of their program. They were sleeping during the day and being up during the night. This brings fatigue. This brings a sense of emotional destabilization to people. We need to sleep during nighttime when our melatonin levels are higher. And sleeping during nighttime is much more beneficial for our brain and our body than sleeping during daytime. Please do listen to me if you wish to be able to cope with this lockdown. Make a time that you go to sleep. Me, myself, I do not sleep very early at night. I usually go to bed at 1 a.m. or 2 a.m. in the morning, and I wake up by 9 a.m. I'm not suggesting you should go to bed at 8 p.m. or 9 p.m. or even 10 p.m. that some people do. Those of you who do, please continue. It's very beneficial. But do not allow your sleep pattern to be disturbed. Don't change it because of the lockdown. You will see, if you do change it, if you do stay up at night and sleep during the day, you will see by yourselves, and I don't want you to see that you will feel fatigue, and you will feel loss of energy, loss of good feelings. You will be something like depressed if you don't sleep during the night and you sleep during the day. The second thing I have to advise to you is to have a program which has some activity for you, and mostly brain activity and physical activity. Brain activity is achieved through working through your laptop or through doing some mental exercises. If you do not have any work to do, you can read a book. You can read a book that is mostly an opportunity for you to expand your thoughts. You can read any self-help book. You can read a psychology book or a philosophy book. You could even read a literature book that would be very helpful for you in order to put your brain to work and to think. Now it's time to read all the classics we haven't read, and now it's the time to read the new editions that we did not have time to deal with them. Thank God, Amazon is working, online bookstores are working, you can order your books online and have reading material. Reading keeps your brain alert. It's a very profound mental exercise. As for physical exercise, those of you who can walk out in nature, because some lockdowns, they have this opportunity in some countries. For example, in Cyprus, when we had the lockdown last spring, you were able to get out of the day one, to get out of your house by sending one message to one specific number. And one of the reasons you could go out once a day was to go walking in nature, or walking your dog. So there are a lot of jokes in Greek sites about people having dogs that they rent to other people so that they're able to get out of the house. If you are able to go for exercise in nature, please do. Please do on a daily basis. And you can do it at a point of the day that is suitable for you. And do it every day at the same time, either in the morning time, or lunch time, or night time, evening time. You can have your daily walk. If you walk at least 30 minutes every day in nature, and when I say in nature, if you live in a city, you can walk around your neighborhood. You don't have to go in the mountains. If you live near the mountains, that's better. You can walk in nature for true. Walking out in nature, physical activity helps you feel better emotionally. If you are not able to do this, there are the houseworks, the house chores. You can do the dishes, you can clean the floor, you can clean the bathroom, you can do house chores that are equal to physical activity and keep your body and your brain activated. Another thing that is very important for this period, psychologically, is to eat healthily. If you eat fresh food with a lot of vitamins, if you eat vegetables, if you eat whole food, if your meals are nutritious and healthy, this can help you have a better psychological mood and emotional mood during the lockdown. And of course, have a better immune system in order to fight the virus, either coronavirus or any other virus that we could catch now that it's the winter as well. In most in our part of the world, it's the winter. So we can have the flu or colds or other viruses, not just coronavirus disease. For people who are willing to make the most of their lockdown and to be able to make a positive outcome through this lockdown period, now it's time for online psychotherapy sessions. Either you had a psychotherapist from before, a psychologist from before that you visited in their office, and now you continue with Skype sessions or online sessions. Either you find now a psychologist of your preference, a psychotherapist, and you start online sessions. Psychotherapy is very beneficial, extremely beneficial in making sense of ourselves, making sense of our feelings, making sense of our emotions, making sense of our inner conflicts. Psychotherapy could be very beneficial. And this period that we stay in the house and we are during lockdown it's a very very positive period for psychotherapy, because we have a lot of time with ourselves, we have a lot of alone time, and during that time we can think again what we said during therapy, and we can work during between sessions with ourselves, because psychotherapy gives us the tools to work with ourselves and our feelings. For those of us that are single and stay by themselves during this time, the lockdown is a very good opportunity in order to establish a good relationship with ourselves, to become good friends with ourselves, to have a healthy relationship with ourselves. We could also try online dating, online dating like this. I was talking with people and they said that now, because of the lockdown in London, for example, some people, instead of meeting on a date on a coffee shop, they met on a virtual date on Skype, and they decided to go for the next date. Meeting people online and talking with people online can be very satisfactory, much more satisfactory than not talking to anybody, not writing to anybody, not looking at anybody. It's proven scientifically in the last months, because a lot of research has been done for online sessions and online psychotherapy sessions, that if you talk with somebody through a video call, you can have a very big connection, much bigger than what we thought before. Before this lockdown experience, we thought that if you talk with somebody through video call, you do not have so much connection with that person as if you are in the same place. It's been proven scientifically that you do not have 100% the same connection, but you do have a lot of connection, like 70% or 85% of the connection you would have if you were in the same room. And nevertheless, if you really aim to have deep communication with other people through video calls, you can achieve that. Of course, you can achieve that. And I am so for video calls. I think that video calls are better than texting, better than phone calls. Video calls are a more rich experience, that you can see the facial expressions of the person who is across you. Now I cannot see your facial expressions because it's a video that you watch, but you can see my own facial expressions. You can see me. If we were on a video chat, we could see each other and communicate, and even through our facial expressions, our voice, our image. Psychotherapy is a very good, online psychotherapy is a very good outcome for people who want to make the most of their lockdown experience. Video calling, a video chatting with people we are already connected with, like good family and good friends, is a very good thing. It's a very good opportunity for this, to reach out to those friends that you didn't have enough time to reach out before, to rekindle all their connections, to see how your friends are doing. Many people have told me that during the first lockdown, they called everybody. They called everybody from their lives. They called their classmates, their teachers, their ex-co-workers. Some of them even called their ex-lovers. Anyway, it's a good opportunity now to really connect with people that we didn't have the time before to do it. I'm closing this video by stating again that being locked down is an unnatural state for human beings. It's so very normal to be upset about it, but please try, for your own benefit, to make use of some of my advice that I have on this video, if you find it interesting, of course, or if you find it that it suits you, in order to cope with the lockdown. I wish that everybody is safe, physically, spiritually, emotionally, and psychologically. Have a nice weekend, everybody. Bye. See you next week with a new video in English. If you liked my video, please share with your friends and family. Bye.